We're Brian and Crystal, and for the past year, we've been traveling around the country in our ProMaster van. We've been in the desert, the tropics, and in extreme heat with no air conditioning. Today, we're going to share with you why we decided not to get AC and the things you may want to consider before you install a unit yourself.
Hey, everyone. Welcome back to Vanhalla Adventures. And today's episode is about why you should not have an AC unit in your van. This is not an anti or hate AC air conditioner video. It's just we're going to go over some things that you might want to consider before you put one in your van. But first, we're going to go take a dip in this river. It's pretty hot out and I need to cool off real quick. You want to go in?
Yeah.
All right.
Sounds great.
Be right back. Love that river.
So after we bought our van, we made a list of our non-negotiables, and air conditioning was one of the top ones for me. I was like, I'm not getting in a van if there is no air conditioner, because I had clients, I knew I was going to be in the van, we were going to be in warm places, and so I thought like van life would be absolutely insane to do without AC. But after we got the van, we didn't know if we were going to build it ourselves, so we talked to some van builders and we got some price quotes and things like that. When we mentioned air conditioning, every single one of them told us not to do it. Also, we met some people on the road who have air conditioning, others who used to have air conditioning and now don't. So we're going to give you all the information that we've gathered on why basically you should not, or some suggestions that, you know, to think about before you build out your van, why we don't have AC and why we really don't suggest it. So we're going to go over all of those right now. So one of the things to think about before you get air conditioning is price point. Price point can vary widely from some of these bigger units, like the rooftop units or the ones that go under your bench or in your bench, can range from about, think about like $1,300 to $5,000, which is a lot of money. So you might be thinking, that's not really a big deal. Great for you. We're going to continue on to some other pointers. But I also want to mention that we have tried some of the portable air conditioners that are little. We got one for like $100.
It was terrible.
Did not work at all. It was one of those things I was like, oh, I'll just put it right in front of me when I have client calls. No, it was absolute garbage. We threw it out. We didn't even gift it to anybody, and it smelled terribly of chemicals.
Yeah.
So I would not suggest wasting your time on air conditioning units like that. If you really are going to get one, I would say kind of like a go big or go home type situation for this. But after factoring all these things in, you might not want to get it. So we'll continue on the next ones. If you're like, price point isn't a big deal, then let's talk a little bit about electric and solar.
Okay, so we're considering air conditioning in your van. If you're cool with the price point, that's good, whatever. But now you gotta think about how much money you're gonna spend on batteries.
And also how much room they're gonna take up.
How much room they're gonna take up. Yeah, batteries are expensive, whether you go AGM or lithium. Just recently watched a guy on YouTube and he just bought a Cruise and Comfort air conditioning unit, which I think is about, $5,000.
Yeah, it's a lot.
And he was saying he's got over 1,000 amp hours of batteries and he could run that AC unit for about 16 hours, but
you can't really do that.
That's the only thing you can do, and you're gonna kill your batteries. You're gonna drain them all the way, and you won't be able to use anything else.
Yeah. Like, it would ruin your batteries. Like, with the non-lithium batteries, the AGM batteries that we have, you really only want to go to about 60%.
Yeah.
So you can really only use about 40%. So you have to figure in, if you're going to use an AC unit, are you also going to be plugging in your laptop? Laptops pull a lot of electricity.
More than you think, especially when they're plugged in all day. Because you need like over 1,000 amp hours of battery to power an AC unit for like a day. Not even a day, just like the hottest part of the day. A huge requirement of power. But if you're gonna be just plugged in at a campsite all day, then you're good. But how often is that gonna happen?
I mean, unless you're like, that's really what you wanna do, then I think AC units would be totally fine for you. But if you're not planning on being plugged in, that air conditioning unit, you can only really realistically run it for a few hours a day, because there's so many other ways to cool down in a van. We'll be making a video about that in a couple of days, so we'll go over exactly what to do instead. But for now, we'll keep continuing talking about this.
Yeah.
So let's say you're like, I'm cool with the price point. I'm going to put $1,000, $2,000, $5,000 down on an AC unit. That's cool. Like, I want to do that. Like, I'm totally fine. I'm going to buy those batteries. And I'm also fine with taking up the amount of room for the batteries. Now we need to talk a little bit about solar and also the room that it's going to also take up in your van in different ways. So let's head upstairs.
Now we're up on the roof, and another thing to think about for a rooftop AC unit is the real estate. As you can see, we have three solar panels here on the roof, and there's no room for an AC unit up here at all. And so you have to think about, if you do put one up here, you're gonna have to have less solar panels on your roof. So not only are you gonna have a big power sucker AC unit in your van, now you're gonna have less solar to recharge your batteries. So I feel like that's a problem, especially if you want to use your AC a lot, which we found out not too many people actually use them a lot. So
yeah, they don't use them very often at all.
Just like a couple hours a day, and it's like thousands of dollars just a couple hours a day.
And lots of real estate.
For me, I don't think it's worth it, but it's your preference. But you know, we're just trying to help you out. So other things to think about are, do you want extra storage up here like we do? We have a Thule Sidekick for storage for extra clothes and whatever camping out adventure stuff. Max Air fan, you're gonna need one of those. Pretty much everybody has one of those. You need that. And so, yeah, there's just, it just takes up a lot of space to put an AC unit up here. I feel like it's not really worth it.
Okay, I wanna mention one more thing about space. So let's say you're like, well, I'm not gonna get a rooftop AC unit. If you get one of the, I think they're called the cruise and comfort units, that's gonna take up space in a bench area, someplace where you can have more storage. So you really have to think, space is super valuable in a van because everything, I mean, even a thing, if somebody gives me a gift and it's like just this tiny handheld thing, I'm like, where am I gonna put that? Like, I always think like, where am I gonna put that? So if you have something that's really, really giant, you have to think, what else am I gonna get rid of in place of that? So something to think about as you're really planning out your build, because there isn't a lot of room. So let's say you're like, I got the money, I got the real estate in the van, like there's plenty of room, I'm not worried about that. Yep. You're gonna plug in all the time. So you're like, totally chill with all of these so far.
Yep.
Okay, another piece is the noise.
They're pretty loud. I just watched the guy install a cruise and comfort unit in his van. He said it was just as loud as if he was outside standing in front of his engine of his van while it's running. It's pretty loud.
It's pretty loud. We met a woman last year up in Idaho and she was like, yeah, I came with it. I ran it for a couple hours. It's so loud, I can't do work. So here was my thought process too. I think that's a huge negative.
Yeah.
That's huge to me. Yeah. And also we've heard of them for the rooftop ones, we've heard of them leaking. Nope.
It just drips. It's condensation. It just happens. Science.
Science, everyone. It's science. So to wrap things up, you have your price point.
Yeah.
Covered electric.
Yeah.
So your batteries, making sure that you have enough battery power even to do it.
Real estate.
Real estate. How much room it's going to take up in the van. Solar.
Solar.
Solar is also a huge one. Noise factor.
Big one.
Yeah. Leakage. That didn't even sound good at all. Leakage.
No.
And all these things. So this is really something, but I would really think about the electric, even making sure you can handle it before you're doing this.
That's the biggest. The biggest expense is paying for the electricity to power the expensive AC unit. The electricity is more expensive than the actual unit. So.
But in all, if you're not plugged in, you're not going to be able to really run them for a full day. So don't count on it.
No.
So I think that wraps up all the reasons we didn't get an AC unit, why we would not suggest, or at least things for you to think about while you're doing your van build. But we are curious if those of you that are watching this do have an AC unit that you love. We'd love to hear about it.
Yeah.
Leave it in the comments. That way other people can check it out. Be like, this is like legit and awesome. We want to know about it too, because hey, maybe for a future van build. But if you're like, okay, well now what am I going to do with without an AC unit? We are going to put out a video in just a couple days from now about how we stay cool in the van, in the summer, in the heat, 90 degrees, 100 degrees. We've done it all. So we're going to be making that video in the next couple days. So be sure to hit that subscribe button. Make sure to hit that bell button as well, so you can be notified if you have not already.
And we'll see you on the next one.
Yeah. Bye everyone. Slow down, mama. Why you talk so mean?